Well, hello there, guys. What's up? It's Pixelated Apollo. Thanks for stopping by. Hope you guys are doing well, and I welcome you to Constantinople. This is the Fourth Crusade. The year is 1202 AD, and Pope Innocent III, originally, he called the crusade to take Muslim-controlled Jerusalem. Well, as the crusader army was headed towards Jerusalem, one of the soldiers, now I quote from history, he said, "You know what empire really grinds my gears? The Byzantine Empire. I mean, what? They call themselves Christian, but they're weird, and they also call themselves Roman. I mean, what's the deal with that?" So all the soldiers agreed that they should change targets, sack Constantinople. Plus, you know, it's a really rich city, so that's another reason. And then bring the Byzantine Empire to its knees. And that's exactly what happened. Look it up. So this is a 4-3. We have 4 attackers, 3 defenders. Now, the settlement is the larger version of Constantinople. It looks very, very beautiful. Also, on the battlefield, I love the fact that there's smoke going up in the air. There's, like, destroyed supply wagons, so it looks like the siege has been going on for a couple months or maybe even years. And not only are you going to see an invasion from land, but you're also going to see an invasion from sea. So you're going to see from sea. You see what I did there? Okay. Anyways, yeah, it's going to be pretty cool, which historically there was about 210 Venetian ships, warships. They heavily outnumbered the defending ships. I think there was like 20 Byzantine ships defending. So I think they were just a little bit outnumbered. Now, for infantry, the defenders had about 15,000 and the crusading army had about 20,000. So it was a little bit more even, you know, speaking infantry wise. But yeah, navy wise, not exactly. So let's look at these army comps. Let me show you the factions really quick. So we have the Republic of Venice. We actually have 3 armies from the Republic of Venice. And then for their navy, they've got the Despotate of Epirus. So yeah, this army should be the Venetians. And I think the land troops, they should be like the Kingdom of France, the Holy Roman Empire, and maybe some Venetian land troops, you know? Because I'm pretty sure Epirus wasn't at the siege, but who knows? Maybe some mercenaries or something. So let's start with the Republic of Venice. Let's look at their troops. And we're going to look at the 3 armies here as if it was one giant army, because I don't really know where one army begins and one ends. So yeah, Venice, all 3 armies are bringing very similar army comps. They've got a lot of great heavy infantry, spears, catapults, and cav. So you can see them on the screen right now. So they've got this special unit. I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm not even going to try, but I think it translates to Marines, something Marines. So he does have some Marine troops, and here's the crossbows over on this side. So yeah, lots of crossbows. Also, a couple rules that I forgot to mention. The attackers could only bring 4 units of archers and I think 2 catapults or 2 artillery, and the defenders could bring 5 units of archers and 2 artillery. But yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. I mean, just very, very similar armies. We have the Doge of Venice in the back. That's always great. Some knights on their heavy shock cav, very bright, colorful uniforms. And then more spears back here. So yeah, that's their force. We do have 1 Venetian army way far away. And again, very similar army comps. Crossbows, heavy infantry, heavy shock cav. Very cool stuff. Let's now look at the navy. So the navy, they've got a good mix of troops. So they've got the heavy infantry in the front, and then in the back he does have his skirmishing forces to support the heavy infantry. And then of course we've got some artillery ships like the catapult ships, and he also has some Greek fire. So where is that fire? It's right in the center. Look at this. Oh yeah. Fantastic. All right, so let's move on to the defenders now. So the defending forces, again, very similar to the Republic of Venice. They all have very similar armies, and I don't know where one begins and one ends. So we're going to look at them once again as one giant army. So the 3 players, they're bringing mostly 2 different types of units. They've got the Scutatoi or Scutatoi. I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm sorry. And then we got the Moratoi. I'm so bad with Greek. I'm really bad with everything. But it's a heavy bow infantry. And now we've got spears back here. Here's the Scutatoi. And then he also has Scutatoi swordsmen. And that's really it, guys. He does have some heavy shock cav, Emperor's bodyguard. It's pretty important to defend the open area of the settlement. So he's going to be using this cav pretty aggressively, I think, you know, trying to prevent any kind of heavy shot cap from the attackers, you know, the Venetian heavy shot cap. But yeah, that's pretty much it, guys, for the armies. We do have some Varangian Guard. Of course, you're going to see the Varangian Guard defend Constantinople. Let's get a close-up. Oh my god, they updated their armor. They look so cool. They look pretty interesting. They look cool. But let's now look at the navy. The navy all just crossbows. No infantry. So that I guess he's going to try to kite the enemy navy. Now he does have some Greek fire. At least he has one Greek fire, which should do a lot of damage as long as he keeps it away from heavy melee and of course the enemy Greek fire. But now that's pretty much it for the army comps. We can now start the battle and begin the fight. All right, so the siege is going to begin with some naval action. The Byzantine Empire has pushed up their ships here, and then of course Epirus is now moving in for the kill. Now obviously Epirus is going to win this naval skirmish, I guess you could say. They're heavily outnumbered, or the Byzantine Empire is heavily outnumbered, so I think the best thing he can do here is try to be kind of aggressive, kite the enemy, take out as many ships as possible. Hopefully he does enough damage to the point where whatever is left of this navy is not that much, and it really won't be a concern once they land on the port or on the beaches here attacking the flanks. And I love this, they've got their troops ready to go. Artillery now fire. Oh, this is so epic. Artillery, oh, it's gonna get a hit and another hit there. Oh, taking out a ton of those troops. Let me turn on the HUD. So are they breaking now? That would break me. That is insane. But this ship is now gonna smash into the side of the crossbows, and the rest of the crossbows are getting awfully close to that Epirus heavy infantry. So they're now falling back. Yeah, the ships are falling back. That's smart. He needs to try to keep his distance because, well, these are crossbows. They're not gonna fight well up close in melee. Oh, what is... Wait, hold on. Where's that Greek fire? I'm going to keep my eye out for the Greek fire. Now, over on this side, over at the walls, just a little bit of a bombardment, some siege towers pushing forward. Nothing too crazy yet, so we're going to head back over to the juicy part where these crossbows are trying to slowly chip away at the navy of Epirus, the despotate of Epirus. Oh, more artillery closing in. Look at that. And getting direct hits. Oh, please... Please burn this. Oh, they're shaking. They're shaking in their boots. Oh, yeah, they're fleeing. Look at that. Look at the jumpage here. Look at this. A lot of them are not making it. They're going into the water, and this ship is done. They're at 41% fire damage because of the artillery that's on the shore. Now, we do have the ships firing back. He's using some catapult ships. Oh, man, I love the navy action in this. It's so awesome. So yeah, he's trying to take out that artillery piece, trying to help his navy. Over here, lots of breakage. Oh, here comes the Greek fire, guys. Please, come on, fire. I want to get a close-up of this one. Oh, he's going to smash in the side of this ship. So that's, it's going down. They're jumping ship, guys. Jumping ship, and that's going to be it for some of the naval forces. But overall, again, the battle is way in favor. And now, has he done enough damage? I don't think so. I think he needs to take down a couple more ships. Now, he does have his Greek fire going towards the enemy artillery and the general. So, oh, look at all the dead soldiers. What are they doing? They're slowly sinking. Oh, wait. You can kind of... You can kind of look under... Oh, it's gone. Sometimes you can see under the water, which would be really cool to see their bodies just sitting, you know, at the bottom of the ocean. But here comes the Greek fire. Let's see if we can get close enough. I'm not going to leave screens. I'm not going to change to a different, you know, point of the battle. I want to see this thing in action. It is taking some pretty heavy casualties and damage from the fire arrows from the general ship, the admiral. So here they go. Oh, there we go. It's like Spitfire. That is awesome. Look at this. Oh my god, it's frying that ship. That is OP as hell. And it's done. It's breaking. It is breaking. Beautiful, beautiful. And now it's pushing up to the next ship. It's not quite in range, but that was pretty cool. I'm just glad we got to see that ship in action as it fought off the artillery ships of Epirus. Now we've got another crossbow ship getting in range, trying to support the Greek fire ship. Oh no, they're shattered. Oh, there goes the other Greek fire ship. Oh, we're gonna have fire versus fire. This is gonna be great. Look at that. Look at that. Is he gonna ram that ship? That would be a great opportunity to ram the ship. They are taking pretty heavy suppressing fire from the general ship. Nope. Yeah, they're gonna be able to get out of there. But they need to hurry up. Oh, there it goes again. Burn it down to the ground. Oh yes, it's on fire. 100% damage. All it takes is a couple seconds of this Greek fire. So when you're fighting something like this, you've got to keep your distance. Stay away. This is a close... I mean, they've got to get close to use their fire. But yeah, always stay away. Let's see what's real quick what's going on with the walls. Let's see. Still pretty slow over here. Just looks so... Look at that. That looks so cool. Oh, screenshot time. That looks so... The distance, the effects... here we go. We've got artillery crashing in. That one misses. Goes straight to the water. They've destroyed a couple of breach points in the walls. They took out a couple artillery... Or not artillery, but arrow towers. Which you really hope they don't. Because they're going to be so important in defense. And the arrow towers are in range of these siege towers. We've got these siege towers really close. But he did not commit to the fight just yet. I think he's waiting to take down more walls. This wall right here looks like it's made out of paper mache. It's down to 82%. So just a couple more hits. That's going to be another breach point. There goes another tower. So yeah, the attacking artillery. They're doing a lot of damage to these walls. I think what the defenders should do is just bluff. They should pretend that they're going to defend the walls and then fall back once they see the Venetian forces advancing. Because what they can do by bluffing, by doing that, making it look like you're going to defend the outer walls, it makes the attacker use up more ammo because he's a little bit more cautious and he's got to knock down more breach points. That way, in the later part of the battle, the later stages, he doesn't have as much ammo to harass your defending troops. So if they can fall back here... Now, I know I say all the time, don't give up the walls, but it's just too big of a wall. There's too many attack points. There's so many breach points. By the way, there's Greek fire on the walls. That is amazing. I didn't know you could put that. That's so awesome. So yeah, the Greek fire, I don't know if I hope we see this thing in action. That would be great. But yeah, the walls are looking rough. And are they falling back? They've got some troops falling back, so I don't know. If he's going to fully commit or not, we'll find out soon enough. Back to this naval fight. It looks like we're in the cleanup phase. Yep, the Byzantine Navy has been destroyed. And Epirus is now free to attack the beaches. Now, Epirus is actually falling back. So, interesting decision there. I'm not sure what they're trying to do. They can actually go right through here. It's pretty thin. But they can go through here and attack the other side. Maybe try to get the element of surprise. But, you know, the Byzantine Empire, they could easily send over reinforcements and get ready. I just hope they attack, like, massive beach landing attack. Because that would be... so awesome. It'd be so epic. But no, they're being kind of hesitant. And I get it. I know why. They're waiting for the land troops to break through here. Oh, actually, we've got our first little engagement. Look at this. Yes, we do. We've got some cav. The Knights of Venice. They're pouring through the streets. And now we got the Byzantine heavy shot cav. I don't know how to pronounce it. But they're charging in. They're charging in and trying to stop this cav. Keep them stuck in prolonged melee. They need to surround and kill this cav. Hopefully, they do not break off and chase down enemy archers. That's another important thing. They are peeling off. Look at this. They're gonna look for vulnerable targets. The Byzantine cav trying to chase them down. And it looks like they are going to be... No, that's what I'm talking about. Oh, my God. They're able to pull off a cav charge against the Gasmuliai, or however you pronounce it. It's a medium crossbow heavy infantry. So that's another thing you've got to watch out for in this big open area. It's so tough to defend. Now we have infantry pouring into the walls, or onto the walls rather. Now they're going to go down the stairway and begin the fight. Yep, here we go. So the siege of Constantinople is underway. So we got a lot of Venetians going down the stairway over at the breach points. Nothing quite yet. The army on this right flank, not charging in just yet, using up some of their ammo. Again, oh, don't take out the fire. Please, I want to see this thing in action. If they destroy the fire, I'm going to be so sad. I just want to see it just spit out some fire on the troops charging in. That would be so amazing. Yeah, it's time to give up the wall. Oh, what are the chances of that? Unfortunate, but only took out about two guys. Yeah, they need to fall back, guys. I mean, like, this is not good. There's no way they can contain the forces. Lots of Venetian troops charging in. Oh, look at this. We got a charge from the heavy shock cav, butchering the very vulnerable Venetian, what are they, the Marines. So they might actually cause them to, yeah, they're wavering. So that was a very nasty cav charge. Doing the best he can of, you know, using his heavy shock cav in this big open area to run down very vulnerable heavy infantry of the attacking forces. And I think he's going to learn his lesson. Don't push too far. Don't go too far away because they will get trampled by enemy cav. I don't know why the minimap was turned off, but there's the minimap. So we have some Rus mercenaries. That's pretty cool. They're helping defend Constantinople. And we've got a very nice port defense, but nothing yet really going on with Epirus. They have not charged in any ships. They're not doing any kind of beach landing. Again, I think they're waiting for their allies to be able to push through. I think once the attackers, if they are able to push over to about right here, I think then the Navy will charge in, because then they're attacking on two fronts really close by, and then they can kind of support each other. So there's more cav fighting going on in this side. Oh, yeah. Got the Dynatoi, I guess, fighting the Knights of the Republic of Venice in this small patch of trees. Oh, look at this. Mother Goose. Mother Goose. I love it. All right, so the cav fight underway. We've got, oh yeah, the infantry still just fighting their hearts out. It's a pretty even battle. So far, I think it's in favor of the Republic of Venice, but Venice needs to be careful. He doesn't want to clump up too many troops, and he needs to get some archers up on the walls. If he can get, he's got archers nearby, but if he can get them up on the walls, that would be a game changer. He would get up, I mean, this is the perfect vantage point. Fire down, kill a ton of the reserves back there. He does have archers firing at the crossbows, taking out quite a few every volley. Let's head back here. Nope, they still have not engaged their troops. So really, they're just focusing the center, trying to break through. I don't know why his ally is not going in as well, the Venetian allies. They should really try to support each other in this fight, because they can easily overwhelm the Byzantine defenders. Because, again, there's so much to defend. So that fight's still going on. Let's see what else is happening. Oh, actually, hold the phone, guys. Hold that phone. We've got the army on the left side of the assault. They're now pushing in their cav. They've actually committed a lot of their cav. We've got a pretty massive cav engagement for the openings of Constantinople. It's very important that the Byzantine Empire wins this engagement. They've got to defeat the enemy cav because, well, if they don't, then they definitely have to retreat from this open area, because the enemy cav will have free, just be able to charge wherever they want. They're going to have no issues whatsoever. So it is vital that the Byzantine Empire wins, or they're victorious in this engagement. Now, it doesn't look good here. Actually, no, it looks good. Looks good, because the Byzantine Empire sent over some infantry. Skoutitoi swordsmen. So that should definitely turn the tables. Tables have been turned. But actually, the Venetian shock cav still doing pretty well against enemy cav and infantry. All right, so let's see. Okay, actually, wow. Okay, so the Byzantine Empire is sending out some cav. They're going back. So I think he was looking for an opportunity, maybe trying to take out the artillery, maybe take out the archers back here, but he decided not to go for it. And he's going to charge into the gate. This is strange. It's like the Venetians are defending Constantinople's walls and the Byzantine Empire is attacking. But no, they're trying to charge back. I don't know what they were really thinking there, but now the cav is stuck in prolonged melee. You don't really want to leave your shock cav in a prolonged melee engagement like this. He is going to try to get them out of there. That's good. I'm glad he's not leaving them in the fight because they will lose a lot of troops there. So he decided to fall back. He could go for the archers, but I think the Venetian player is well aware of this cav, and he's going to be able to protect his archers against any, like, cav charges, anything like that. Back this way, finally, the Venetian knights are starting to waver against the Byzantine Empire in their heavy infantry. Let's see. Oh, we've got, yeah, the fighting. Oh, man, the fighting is getting a little bit out of control for the Byzantine Empire. The Venetians are taking control, and the Scudatoi swordsmen are surrounded on two fronts, fighting back to back against the Venetian horde. Still nothing here. I mean, this is amazing that he's just letting his ally just fight alone like that. Just really surprised by that. Now, the other player storming in, I don't know why it took him so long to charge in. There's really nothing waiting for him. He does have some shock cav, though, he's got to look out for. I think the Byzantine Empire is going to wait for a perfect opportunity to charge. In fact, he could charge right now. These are not spears. They're not any kind of pikes. They're just heavy infantry. Whenever you charge heavy infantry, just make sure you get out. Just don't leave your cav in the fight. Just charge. Do cycle charges. Get them in, get them out. And you can do a lot of damage. All right, so let's see. Yeah, more infantry grouping up. So yeah, it does appear that the Venetians are grouping up. The cav is still storming this way. So the Byzantine Empire still hopeful of getting some good cav charges, maybe taking out vulnerable targets. But it doesn't look like it's gonna happen because Venice is now engaging some of their cav as well. Let's actually get the first person view of this. So they're storming through the trees. Reports of enemy forces are oh wait, there's the charge. There's the Byzantine charge. I really don't know who's better in this situation. I think it's pretty even. They're both heavy shock cav. They're both tier 2. Again, I'm hoping for the Byzantine Empire. I'm kind of rooting for the Byzantine Empire because they're defending and the odds are not looking great for them. They are starting to break here. So this is now definitely red alert. You gotta fall back. Because this fight here at the wall is over. Guys, it's over. There's no way you're going to be effective in defending this. Now, good job here burning down the siege tower. He needs to get his men out of there pretty quickly or they're going to just die. Amazingly, there's nobody like suffocating from the fire and the smoke. There they go. They've got to hurry up, though. It's at 22. They'll make it. Wait, where are they going? Whoa. Whoa. They're going under the ground and then appearing above it. Amazing, truly amazing. We do have defending artillery firing. Actually, yeah, it's the what? So the Greek fire spits out like these fiery balls that don't go too far, and I think that's why this thing is on fire. So yeah, I think he's got to go through the breach points. That's the only way of him getting through the walls because of the Greek fire. That's pretty cool though. I'm glad we got to see that in action. Okay, so now the center has been broken through, and the Venetians are charging in their heavy infantry, looking for vulnerable targets. We've got crossbows who are now breaking to the site of the very deadly Venetian heavy infantry, and the cav still doing nothing, not charging in. Again, I think they're just waiting for their allies. They do have two ships over on this side as well, so maybe he's going to wait for a little flanking charge. I don't know. He's just being very patient, which is, you know, good strategy, good tactic. Oh my god, yeah, this is really concerning. The Byzantine cav now breaking too many Venetians to fight. Light melee infantry pouring in. Communal swordsmen from Venice. So it's hard to tell what's going on when you zoom in, but of course when you zoom out you get a much better picture. And finally, it looks like the Byzantine Empire is deciding to fall back. They're going to hold the choke points of the street. I mean, this is a really cool street right here because it's just one giant long choke point that the Byzantine Empire can defend. I still think they should fall back though. I think there's no point in trying to defend this wall. You've lost the wall over there. So what do you get at defending this wall? Nothing. You get death. That's what you get. Because you're going to get outflanked. There's no way. If there's one wall, part of the wall that's lost, there's no way you're going to defend the other. Because, again, they're going to attack on the side of where they were victorious, on that side of the wall. Just retreat your men. Retreat your men, defenders. Please, get them out of there. We do have a stand of some heavy, or actually medium, spear infantry. And they can see some advancing Venetians. Oh, yeah, look at that. That looks so cool. Look at them back there. They're eager to kill. The spears have got their spears down. Shield wall formation, men. Tighter formation. Here they come. We defend this location to the death. Probably not to the death, but for a while. There's the charge. So they're now protecting the flank, which is fine. But, I mean, this should be avoided right now. I mean, really, all they should be focusing down is right here. This is all that they should be worried about. Defending right here, and then over on this side, which he does have some pikes. But I'm pretty sure he's going to use his... Yep, he's going to use his skirmishers. You can see the skirmishers lining up behind the heavy infantry. They're going to soften up the pikes before the heavy infantry charges in. There's the heavy archers of the Byzantine Empire trying to fire back. We've got heavy shock cav. Oh, wait, we got more... What if... Oh, no. Okay, for a second, I thought this was Byzantine cav. It's like, where is he getting this cav? What is this? But finally, the heavy infantry is now taking out the Greek fire, which is really disheartening. And he's still trying. Okay, so he's got some medium skirmishers trying to support his heavy infantry, his heavy spear or medium spears. He really shouldn't try to defend this. I know I sound like a broken record right now, but they've got to fall back. They don't have enough troops. They can still win this one. I know the balance of power doesn't look great, but they're only down less than 2,000 men, which can change quickly as a defender. You just got to use your artillery, your archers, fall back to less points, less locations where you have to defend. But instead, the defenders just desperately fighting for the wall. So more spears have joined the fray against... The foot knights. Oh, that's going to be nasty trying to fight them. The foot knights. Back here, there is a fight for the breach point on this side. So the spears are shaken. And unfortunately for the spears, the Venetians are very happy. And they can sense a victory any moment now. Over in this area. Not on the overall battle, of course. Alright, so some archers are falling back. Thank goodness he's getting his archers out of there. Oh, yep. Man, I think this is a little bit overkill from the attackers. Like, I get it. They're trying to win. But to just sit back and fire at the defending troops. I mean, come on. Look at the advantage you have. Is that really necessary? And now he's moving up a catapult. This is hilarious. I've seen this so many times. He's going to use this catapult. I can just feel it. He's going to use it to break this formation. So whenever you have a catapult that's used up all its ammo, just push it forward into some heavy infantry. And it'll break the formation. By the way, look at this. They formed a shield wall around the statue. That looks really cool. Yeah, there it goes. See, they're just like, oh, how dare you push this catapult? There's nothing I can do about it, though. Seriously, the shield wall can't prevent the catapult from advancing into their ranks. Now we got the Venetian heavy infantry. They're charging into the fight. And we've got another set of Venetian heavy infantry going in as well. So, yeah, pretty rough start so far from the Byzantine defenders. Their navy has been burnt to a crisp. It is gone. And their infantry have already lost the outer walls. The balance of power is not looking great. But again, anything is possible in Total War if the defending players just recover. They've got to make smart decisions here on out throughout the battle. And one of the smart decisions is just giving up a lot of the territory and falling back over to the town center. Now, they do have a lot of reserves here, so they still have quite a few troops. Oh, here we go. Here comes the beach landing. Sure enough, guys, just like I said, he's waiting for his allies to get a little bit closer, and he can support his allies by attacking the defenders on multiple fronts. Archers going after the catapult back there. Oh, watch out. Boom, nice. Good hit. Direct hit right there. The swordsmen, man, they're get him! Chop his head off! Defend your home! Defend it to the last man. All right, so here comes the heavy infantry of the naval support. So let's watch them. Dismount from the, not dismount, but unboard, whatever. They're coming to the shore. That's what I'm trying to say. The heavy infantry is going to cause a lot of issues for their back lines. They have nothing protecting the catapult. Here comes another volley, though. Let's see if it gets any good hits. Oh, come on. Close. We've got more artillery advancing from the attackers. Gonna use the artillery. Actually, this doesn't have any ammo, so he might be using it like the like his ally, just pushing through. But actually, they're holding here against the Venetians. You know, they're not gonna hold forever, but they're causing some of them to break. Oh yeah, look at the wave. Oh, fantastic. The wavering is nice. Now he's committing more troops. He's upset. He's gonna use just his numbers to break through. And hopefully that will prevent the infantry to stop wavering. But unfortunately, no, his spears are going to break from the fight. I think it was the archers. The archers did a lot of damage to the defenders, or the attackers, excuse me. So he is falling back his heavy bows. There's some really concerning breach points here. This is not good. We've got communal swordsmen chopping up some archers. I mean, again, look at the position. Okay, let's take a second here. Let's slow-mo it real fast. Look at this. Tactical view. So, this is not good. As a defender, you never, ever want to get in this situation, because as a defender, you are, well, in terms of infantry, you're at a disadvantage because you have less money, you have less troops. Whenever you get cut off like this, you're going to lose so much potential in your defense. You see how they're surrounded. They're getting attacked here. And now we've got the other army closing in. They're going to be able to surround and just butcher these forces. So he needs to get them out of there. Try to rescue some of them, because they're going to be very useful at the final stands over at the other parts of the battle. Oh, we got a cav charge going on over at this side. I think the cav is... Oh, no. Don't tell me they're charging. Yep, they're going after archers. That's another thing as a defender you need to do. You've got to protect your archers. Archers are so vitally important that if you don't have any archers late game, it's over. Game over. So let's see if he can rescue them. Let's go back to normal speed. Sorry about that. Doing some slow motion. Does he have anything? He's got the Varangian Guard, which I'm really excited to see in action. Because, you know, Varangian Guard, such a cool unit. But they need to turn around and support those archers, but it's too late. The archers are gone. He is charging in some spears. I'm really sorry about the framiness, guys. It's just because the settlement is ginormous. There's a lot of troops on the battlefield, and there's also a lot of fire going on. So it's causing some frame rate issues. I'm really sorry about that. But anyways, the heavy shot cav finally is defeated. They're like, fall back. The spears are too many. We pursued the archers a little too far. Now this is just death for the defenders. They're getting attacked by two fronts. Their artillery is gone. The Scrutatoi swordsmen fighting off this Guard Marines unit from Epirus. Actually, are they breaking some of the units? Yeah, they are breaking. Yeah, look at that. Pretty cool. That's nice. I mean, it's still like these guys are going to get butchered, but at least they're putting up a fight. And I'm sure they're happy to kill, you know, soldiers from Epirus. How dare you betray us, you bastard. But now that they, the communal swordsmen are free to roam around, is he going to go back? No, he's going to pursue this way and continue the push. The Byzantine Empire, I think they're kind of giving up here. They're forming square formation because they are surrounded. There's nowhere else to go. Look at the banners over here. Look at that. That is cool. I've never seen, it's like the burnt down structure. You got banners. I've never seen that in Total War Attila. It looks pretty awesome. We also have a small fight here. Again, he's got his square formation. And I guess he's just trying to delay the attackers. You know, I'm really pulling for a defending, like, miracle. I hope these defenders can turn this around. If they can save some of their artillery and a lot of their archers, anything's possible. I feel like the attackers have used up most of their supplies. You know, they've used up most of their artillery ammo, their archer ammo. So if the defenders are a little bit smarter in that regard, if they can, you know, hold on to their ammo, then they definitely have a shot at winning this one. Trying to take out the square formation now. These men are down to 67 as they take on 76 Marines. It's going to be a tough fight for them, and I'm pretty sure, yeah. Why don't these guys just charge in? Just end it. Just end this fight. But yeah, Venice is just holding back some spears. Just going to let Epirus take care of that. What's left of the defending forces is right here. The spears, they're surrounded. The attacking forces are regrouping, advancing their troops, getting ready for the final push of the siege of Constantinople. And now, okay, yep. This is the last of the square formation. Square formation definitely will help you hold out for a lot longer. But when you're so heavily outnumbered, again, it's only a matter of time until it's over. But maybe that's what he's trying to do. Maybe he's just trying to delay the attackers. You know? He's just trying to prevent them from advancing too quickly on the Byzantine defenses. The inner defenses. So what do we have here? We've got some spears. We've got a lot of archers. And some javelins. So he's got his skirmishers. And then he's got an inner defense with the generals. I see two generals, three generals all present at the town center. He's got more troops here. He does have the rear guard of the Byzantine, the Varangian Guard, which is cool. I like the fact that the Varangian Guard are kind of like the final stand. I hope to God they put up like a killer fight. Just unbelievable last stand as they butcher these forces. Maybe even trying to turn this one around. And here comes the rest of Epirus's navy. Some archer fire. I'm seeing some arrows fly into these ranks, but nothing too effective. So I think they're just waiting for reinforcements. There we go. Here comes the next wave. Onboarding. Get off the ship. They're going to charge. So we got the rest of the army right here. We've got crossbows, heavy bow, infantry. Remember, well, oh, geez, this is bad. I was going to, you know, change. Let me change my thought process here. I was going to say something, but let me focus on here. Wait. Okay, so maybe I got confused there. It looked like the catapult had a lot of ammo, but I think it was actually just the crossbow ammo that was running by. It looked like the catapult ammo. I'm very confused, but yeah, he's going to move up his archers, which still have more than half of their ammo, which is not good. What they're going to do is just sit back and fire at these guys. Yeah, they're going to sit back, fire at them, because there's really no need to charge in the heavy infantry when you have the advantage of the archers. Now, I think they should just for battle's sake, because they already have like such a huge advantage. Here comes some just like last minute charges from the Byzantine Empire of some hopeless units that are surrounded. And they're going to get butchered, surrounded by the knights, the Doge of Venice, captured prisoners. Okay, so the armies are lining up, the artillery. I think he's using the catapults again to push through the formations. So, okay, there's only two choke points here. And then, of course, we've got a choke point back here. Another path, you know, where they can attack. It doesn't really... Oh, we got a cav charge. Look at this! The general's getting into the fight, guys. Beautiful. Okay, so he realizes at this point in the battle, he's got to get his general in the fight if he wants any chance of winning this one. So he's going to charge in. What did he... he charged into some heavy medium melee, but he needs to get them out again. He needs to do cycle charges. There he goes. It's like he's reading my mind, falling back, and hopefully... I mean, honestly, he should just go back. He took too many casualties there. It's not worth it to lose your general, because the army will break so quickly without your general. Okay, so very, very wise. I'm actually really glad they're doing this. They're giving up this location, because it's just one too many... It's one choke point too many. He needs to just fall back where there's just one choke point. Yeah, just get everyone at the town center. This is red alert mode. It's time to fall back and just put up the last stand of your life. Just hope for a miracle. By the way, guys, 73% of this settlement has been destroyed. So that's going to hurt them. Minus 13 morale, melee attack, and melee defense. That is disgusting. That is a large amount of a disadvantage. But here comes the Venetians. They're now attacking this side. We also, of course, have the Marines who are coming ashore to support the land forces of the Republic of Venice. So we're kind of at a slower part of the battle where the attackers are just, you know, kind of getting ready their forces to attack. Now, actually, on this side, we do have a bit of a stand-up. Oh, Venice. Venice getting chewed up. And here comes the spears to finish the job. Let's see. They're in shield wall. Marching. Okay, they're just getting a little bit closer. Yeah, just let the... Oh, wait. We've got... No, never mind. I thought that was Byzantine cav back there. It's a friendly cav for the Venetians, for the attackers. But yeah, let the archers clean up these guys. You know, take them out. That's good. Back here, we do have some pikes who are defending against the cav of Venice. So they're going to defend the streets. Yeah, they can defend right there. That's a good spot. There's really not too many archers on this side, so that's good. They don't have to worry about the archers. Really, most of the archers are massing over here, which is going to cause a lot of issues for these defending forces. Hopefully, they don't clump them up like this. He needs to spread them out, get them in loose formation, get them to waste their ammo. He's got his swordsman in shield wall, which should protect him from arrows a little bit. But maybe he's just trying to use this unit as a bit of a sacrifice unit against the archers. Try to get them to waste their ammo. Oh, come on. Come on, just charge in the infantry. Just give Byzantine some kind of hope. All right, so we've got some fighting here with the Republic of Venice charging in their heavy melee infantry against the medium spear infantry. The Marines, two layers of Marines are sitting in reserve. The archers, the Byzantine archers, are now using their arrows to try to soften up the reserves. Which is something they must do if they're going to win the fight. Because these spears cannot win without some kind of archer support. Now the first row of reinforcements are advancing into the fray. And they're going to support the Venetian spears, Venetian heavy infantry, against the Byzantine spears. Oh, here we go, guys. We've got some troops advancing this way now. And I think they're going to charge in. The archers are now softening up the back reserves. I think they're going after the defending archers. Oh, here's the charge. Oh, we kind of missed it, but that's all right. We see the aftermath. Or we saw the aftermath. So... both tier 2 heavy infantry, the Venetian heavy infantry looks a little bit better. You know, they look cooler, I guess. I don't know how effective they are, stats-wise. So it's tough to say who's going to win this engagement. But with all that archer support from Venice, I'm pretty sure they're going to come out on top. Oh, I think we got fighting going on this side, too. Oh, this is so cool. He's got, yeah, some medium skirmishers lined up. And this little flanking, I wish there was more stuff like this in siege battles. Just having a little defensive location, making it difficult for the forces to advance. We do have some guard marines who just kind of glow in the shade here. My god, they look weird. Oh, another, yeah, he needs to get his skirmishers out of there. There's no point in just leaving them there. They're going to get chewed up. And let's see, who's winning the fight in melee? Unit losing decisively. Okay, so yeah, they don't really stand a chance. He is sending up some reserves. The Byzantine Empire mobilizing their forces. Got to defend Constantinople. This is it, guys. The final stand of Constantinople. Will the Byzantine Empire come out on top? Or will they lose the city? Just like, you know, history will repeat itself. So the crossbows up on the slope, firing over the buildings. He's going for the back reserves of the cav. There's so many troops left. Looking at the number of troops. Yeah, oh yeah. Outnumbered by more than 2,000 now. So they don't have any artillery. The defenders do have zero artillery, which is really a shame. Because that's something you desperately need in situations like this. And the fact that they were not able to save any of their artillery is a really concerning sign. Oh, someone just lost their head from a spear. Must be a huge spearhead. So the Marines are starting to waver, though. Kind of pushing themselves a little too hard against the Byzantine Empire. The archers are getting some good kills. There they go. They're breaking. So, yeah, the Byzantine Empire able to hold their ground. Just when I thought this fight was over, the Byzantine Empire turns it around. They're going to need a lot more of that if they want any chance of winning. And, oh, my God, look at this mass of forces fighting for the streets. And oh, that's so cool. Got the statue in the background. So Venice trying to muscle their way through. Of course, they've got the archer support. They're taking some heavy casualties, though, from the archers, who are also taking some pretty heavy casualties, but not as bad because they're not as grouped up as the Venetian infantry or the Venetian archers. So thankfully, he's fallen back his skirmishers. It would have been really cool to see them in action over here, but they've got no answer to the skirmishers of Venice. And oh my God, look at the army over here. It's ridiculous. Just ridiculous. I think this is mostly the naval units. Yeah, this is Epirus that's going to be flanking around. All right, so we got breakage from both sides. The Byzantine Empire and Venice is starting to break as this fight continues to get very intense. The archers, I mean, it's just endless number of arrows going over the heads of the soldiers taking... Oh, no, the heavy archers are starting to waver for the Byzantine Empire. Not a good sight. Very bad sight. Oh, the Byzantine Empire now going to have to fight some cav. These brave spearmen fighting as if they're Varangian guard. In fact, if they do live through this battle, I'll promote them to Varangian guard because they're fighting so... I mean, it doesn't really work like that because Varangian Guard, I'm pretty sure they're Nordic. You know, they're not even like truly Byzantine native forces. I'm sure there was like some native troops in Byzantine units, you know? Like it wasn't just all Nordic forces. I don't know. I'm no expert, so I'm sure someone will tell me in the comments. Okay, lots of breakage here. This is really good for the Byzantine Empire. Lots of swordsmen, they're tired, they've been fighting all day. In fact, all of the swordsmen, they need to push up the spears. Get them in the fight. Try to take advantage of the situation where they are just massive break from the Venetians. And the archers, I mean, if they can try to get to those archers, take them out, they're going to save a lot of lives. Let's see, have they advanced this way? No, not yet. Not yet. The archers, oh, they're going to try to slowly advance. The skirmishers are getting a little bit closer. They're going to try to take out some of those archers. Or not. Maybe they're just trying to get the perfect angle. Yeah, we got a lot of skirmishers. They're taking it nice and slow over on this flank. I love this town center of Constantinople. It is really cool. Unfortunately, the spears have broken. But they fought so well. You can't be mad about that. And there's another layer of defense here, so it's not that big of a deal. There's swordsmen. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. No. No, get your spears out of there. No, this is it for the Byzantine Empire. Oh, God, that is disgusting. That was unfortunate. So you got to be aware of those type of things. You can't leave flanks open like that. No, no, no. Why is he charging down more spears? Now they're getting trampled by Venice. Venice, why? So the spears are dying. Fall back, spears, please. Please. Oh, I'm sorry, guys. Just got a Steam message. Really sorry about that. Let me, How did he send a message? I'm appearing offline. Oh, well. Yeah, if you're on my friends list, try to avoid sending me messages if you see me playing, like, Total War. It doesn't matter. It happens. It's not a big deal. But anyways, they're breaking, which is really concerning. Back here, let's see, what do we have? We got cav. So the Byzantine Empire still has some cav left over. I don't know what he's trying to do with the cav. Maybe going to do, like, a surprise attack. The Venetian cav is starting to break. Come on, please. So sorry, guys. So sorry. I don't know how he's sending in messages like that. Because I am appearing offline. But medium pike infantry advancing on this side. So, yeah, he's going to try to take... And he's going to fall back. Look, that's pretty smart from Venice. Because why engage? You're going to lose the fight against the pike. So fall back. And there's no need to engage because you're winning on other flanks. Oh, actually, Byzantine Empire still has a decent number of troops here. So they still have a solid number. So they're actually doing quite well, but this is a problem. This right here, I mean, there's still a ton of troops. Yeah, it looks like it's close, but let's see. Let's look at the numbers now. Well, it's still pretty bad. Oh, God, the charge. The charge with the cav. I don't know what the Byzantine Empire was thinking there. Where's the Varangian Guard? Please, I want to see them in action. Here they are. I just want to see them put up one hell of a stand. That's all I can ask for. They are falling back in the very back ranks. Everybody just needs to fall back to the town center. Just hold like two ranks right here. Just get everybody back. Fall back, please, everybody. Again, you're at a very bad situation. We got this thin line of swordsmen who are going to hold against three thick units of swordsmen, the communal swordsmen of Venice. Oh, some arrows coming in. Look at this. Pew, pew, pew. Oh, nice. Trying to weaken them up a little bit. Now we got spears trying to support the swordsmen who are holding against this flank. There goes the charge of the communal swordsmen. Oh, yeah, they're breaking through here. So yeah, the flank is now gone on this side. The Varangian Guard. I just want to see them fight. Where's the other Varangian Guard? I know there's two of them. Oh, what is he doing with this one? Get them in the fight. Fight to the death. Okay, so they are breaking the troops, the swordsmen over at the courtyard. Venetian cav infantry getting ready to advance into the next wave of Byzantine defenders. Communal swordsmen going in for the kill. And we have the general staying close by, trying to keep his men's spirits high. They can still pull this off. They just need a miracle. The Varangian Guard need to go on a rampage. In fact, I don't know why he's not sending in the Varangian Guard over here. He needs to send them in. Just throw them in. They'll get tons of kills. Come on. Where are they going? No, not that way. You've got plenty of troops over here. You don't need to send reinforcements. No. Send them over here. This is the biggest concern right now. I mean, his defenders are so heavily outnumbered. I swear to God, if the Varangian Guard, if they're just going to run around like this, I'm going to be so sad. I'm going to be very sad. You don't want to make me sad. Come on. Yeah, there they go. There they go. They're going to join the fight. They're fresh. They've got 150 men out of 150, and they're going to kick some ass, guys. They're going to take out there they go. Oh, the Varangian Guard reinforcements. I don't think you could ever be more excited for any kind of reinforcements other than Varangian Guard reinforcements. I mean, when you see them show up as reinforcements, it's a cool sight. It's a nice sight. All right, so the Varangians should be able to hold here for a pretty long time. Let's see what's going on. Okay, so they're still holding. The general is in the fight. The pikes, unfortunately, breaking. This general is obviously going to fight to the death for the Byzantine Empire. Not a good sight there. They're about to lose their first general in the battle. And this entire flank is pretty much lost. He does have one unit of Varangian Guard just waiting in reserve. He might as well retreat them back. He should retreat this unit back as well. Just get them all to the town center. Just less areas to defend. The better. Alright, so let's go back. See this Varangian Guards in action. Oh, wait. Yeah, there goes the general. Oh, no, they're breaking. The spears are breaking, so it's all up to the Varangian Guard. Might as well just throw in the swordsman. The frames are also breaking as well. Come on, Varangian, you got this. It's only a couple thousand. That's it. Just a couple thousand. So yeah, the swordsmen have been committed to the fight. Where are... Okay, yep, here's the Varangian Guard. Varangian Guard are gonna get charged by the cav, though. Yep, see. Oh no! The general stops the cav charge for the Varangian Guard out of nowhere. The Byzantine general, that was awesome. So COVID out of nowhere, supporting the Varangian Guard. Varangian Guard are gonna join the fray and help out their general, or one of the generals. So very cool situation there. But unfortunately, more Venetian infantry is storming the streets. And I think the last of the reserves on the center defense is now engaged. So the Byzantine Empire has fully committed their army. They still have some cav back here. Just waiting for... I mean, what are you waiting for? Just go in at this point. You're going to need them. Maybe he's going to try to... Well, he could try to sneak around, maybe? No, he really can't sneak around. He should just send the cav over to this side and help out the fight over here. Varangian Guard, charge in, please. Give him the good old charge. Tell him what for. Break. Actually, don't charge the pikes. Don't charge the pikes. Please. There we go. Now charge them. Now charge them. Their pikes are not in formation. Nice. That's pretty good. So it's down to the Varangian Guard as they fight for Constantinople. So the Varangian Guard still have 115 men. They are so tough. And here comes some cav. We've got the, finally he's activated the cav, protecting the flank of the Varangian Guard. So that was actually pretty smart from him. Just awaiting for the flank of the Venetians. But I'm pretty sure this cav is not going to win the fight. It says combat is even, but they are outnumbered. Because this cav unit is pretty depleted. It's down to 42. This one's down to 59. So laggy over here. When you look... See, when you look in this... Look at that. That looks so cool. But when you look in this direction, that looks amazing, guys. Look at that. Anyways, what I'm trying to say is it's just framey because there's so much stuff over there. But as soon as you turn away from it, it's much better. It's like night and day. Ah, the Varangians are breaking. That's unfortunate. And then back here, the Varangians are just having a tough time against those pikes. And it looks like that's going to be it for the Byzantine defenders. So yeah, this was most definitely not a balanced battle. I think it was a little unfair for the defenders. It wasn't exactly a close battle either, but sometimes with these big battles, you just get what you get, you know? You can't really... I mean, it's tough to set these up. Even just to have this replay is pretty awesome. So yeah, pretty cool fight though. I love how it's just fighting all over the place, and this is what's left. I think 73% of the city has been burned to the ground. Look at that. Constantinople has been trashed in this siege, and that's a close victory. It says it's a close victory, but you know, from my standards, it was pretty decisive. Let's end the replay and look at the results of the armies. So yeah, lots of armies on the battlefield. This was sent in by Sultan Edard Stark. So thank you, man, for the battle replay. Thank you to all the players who fought in this one. It was really fun. But yeah, here's the kills of the armies. Just real quick show you guys. And then here is the kills for the Byzantine Empire. So that's going to wrap up the Fourth Crusade, kind of. This is going to be it for Constantinople for a while. I'm pretty sure the Byzantine Empire gets it back a little bit later. But yeah, that's going to wrap it up, guys. Thank you so much for joining me in this pretty long siege battle. And I'll see you next time.